They're about to be visited by an eco-auditor.
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line. Engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup.
What's going on?
One flush can use up to 15 litres of water. So that looks like a rather unsustainable flush to me. Obviously not a low-flow showerhead. The eco-auditor cannot be happy about this. The eco-auditor's really going for it now. Oh, and the old Australian icon, the Hills Hoist, taking up quite a lot of space in this rather industrial landscape. Oh, here we go. The eco-auditor's going to be right at home here. This looks like a recycling bin. So we have the final scorecard here from the eco-auditor. And there seems to be a lot more in the bad column than in the good. Some definite goodies are the seals in the fridge. Looks like there is actually some bicycles in the house. And, look, he even says the housemates are nice. You can't really pick that up in his body language. But anyway, looking over in the bad, and that's just about everything else in the house. It's a real grilling on their level of sustainable living. What exactly is the problem here?
Well, the problem is that these musos think they're pretty cool, but their actions are actually bringing about the warming of the planet.
This means we're coming back tomorrow and we're going to be making changes.
Well, at least you thought we were nice people.
Here we are, day two, out the back of number 9, and the housemates tentatively await the arrival of the eco-auditor. How are you feeling, you know? Vibe, you know, scared, worried?
Well, there seemed to be a lot of problems yesterday that he identified, so I guess a bit nervous about exactly how he's going to fix them.
It's not something to take lightly, is it?
Well, no, I'm extremely nervous, actually.
Here he comes now, and this is the man who gave quite a rather negative scorecard yesterday.
Let me see you.
Everybody, you'll find tools in the tubs and in the bags, and just get started on the weeding.
So Rosa, what are you doing to this lovely choco plant?
It is not a choco plant, it's a weed.
And so you're getting rid of it?
Yes, and you got to be careful because it's got a milky sap that can burn you.
Rosa informs me that this white sap can cause mass infertility. Is that true, Rosa?
No, just skin burns and allergies.
So we have Sif and Joachim here converting the old barbecue.
This is where all the kitchen scraps and household organic waste and some garden green waste can go in and decompose and become yummy food for the veggies.
Now Rosa, this looks like a sustainable solution for your itch. What are you doing?
I'm just rubbing the aloe vera to cool it down. The vine at the back caught me.
So it appears Rosa's in serious danger of becoming infertile.
Yeah, I had a look outside and I felt like I was maybe getting in the way a bit.
Saturday morning, our heads were sore. Feeling seedy, we opened the door. Who is this guy? Nobody was sure. He said, I'm the eco-auditor. Like the nappy sand challenge, but heaps more intense. He's saving the earth and fixing our fence. He opened the ovens, he looked at the lights, he crossed all our wrongs and he ticked all our rights. Cool communities, now we're living the way we ought to be. So sustainable, so sustainable. Now we see that it's heaps obtainable.
Shame.
What would you think if I sang out a tune? Would you stand?
We've got sunflowers, we've got beans, we've got capsicums, we've even got some eggplants in the centre there I can see. We've got some cucumbers as well growing. We've got some dill, we've got some black zucchini. I believe we've even got some rock melon, and not to mention the rather large macadamia tree. This isn't actually waste. You may be looking at it thinking that it's waste, but it's not waste. These are simply resources that have not yet been used. For example, a rain shelter. So here we have yet another major improvement for the household, and that is an all-in-one compost bin and worm garden, and that's something even our housemates, I think, are capable of. Simply, the only thing these pets need to be fed is compostable waste. Sustainable living is not just about design improvements, but it's also about utilising unused space and unused resources. And here's a perfect example of the Eco-Auditor doing just that by putting a mushroom kit in here, which when left alone and with a little bit of moisture over time, will produce in about 8 weeks some healthy mushrooms for the housemates to consume. In fact, this is probably the happiest bedhead I've seen yet, simply being at the head of the garden bed. So where does this leave the housemates of number 9 in this rather quiet street in suburban Sydney? Well, I can tell you, they may have energy efficient light bulbs, they may have low flow shower heads, but what we can't give the housemates is the ability to make sustainable decisions from here on in. I'm Ben, this is Fly TV, are your decisions sustainable? Goodbye.